Hello and welcome back to the To-Do List, the show where we are one by one striking things off of our creative to-do lists. Today is going to be a little bit unlike some of the other episodes of the To-Do List. I don't know how this episode is going to go, and that's what makes it different. This might be a complete waste of time and a complete failure. And you might be saying to yourself, hey, that describes all of the videos you've made. And to that, I would say that that's very mean. So, what I'm going to be doing today is I'm going to be trying to start a campfire without using a lighter, without using matches, without using flint, but instead using what is called the bow and drill method. This is where you use a piece of wood and a string and a second piece of wood to essentially create your fire through friction. And if for those people who don't know what friction is, you can probably find out what that is on Google, because I'm not a science teacher. Okay, fine. Rub your hands together. Do they get warm? Congratulations, that's friction. So I'm going into this video completely prepared to fail miserably. So let's see how it goes. First, I'm going to start off by making my bow. I'm going to take a piece of wood and I'm going to cut out a curved piece of it. And then I'm going to drill two holes in the end. I'm then going to take a piece of thin rope and I'm going to tie it between these two holes that I've drilled. The next step is I'm going to make the spindle part of my bow and drill. This is going to be the part that is actually going to create the friction that hopefully will ignite our fire, which is just going to be made out of a wooden dowel that I'm going to cut out to be smaller. So now I'm going to bring the ends of my spindle to a point. All right, it looks like I have everything that I need for this project.
We got my little pile of kindling just, you know, on the off chance that this actually works. Got my base here, and I've cut a groove into one of the pieces of wood so that the spindle will stay in place. And then I've got another kind of top base that I'm going to put on top of it so that it stays in the right place.
So here's what I'm trying to do. I am trying to spin the bow and drill on another piece of wood, and that's going to create a bunch of friction, but it's also going to create a bunch of this little kind of like wood sawdusty stuff. And if I'm able to go fast enough with the bow and drill, then I'm going to create an ember, a little glowing red, almost little spark thing. And on the side, I have a little bundle of dryer lint, which is very, very flammable. So what I'm hoping to do is I'm hoping to get that ember in that little pile of sawdust and then transfer it over to my bundle of dryer lint. And then I'm going to add oxygen by blowing into it. Hopefully that is going to ignite the dryer lint, and then I can start building the fire on top of that. Oh my god, I was so close. I had the glory in my hands for but a second, and then it was torn away from me. I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm getting discouraged. It's hard.
Got another ember.
So, I had some problems with my first bow, so I made a new one. It's new and improved because I needed it. I needed to make changes. Just kidding, I got angry and I threw it on the ground and it broke. Maybe the lesson here isn't a lesson about perseverance and resilience. Maybe it's a lesson about
taking a loss with grace. I think I'm doing that. It's not giving up. It's recognizing when a task is just plain stupid. Yeah, that's what it is.
Well, I'm back inside now, and my arms really hurt, and I'm tired, and I'm sweaty, and I'm sad. But you know what? There is always tomorrow. There's a good chance I'm gonna be trying this tomorrow. So thanks for joining us on this disaster of an episode of the to-do list. I hope the things that you're trying go a little bit better than this thing went. So thanks, and goodbye.